Getting my voice? Students, getting my voice?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So today I will discuss 4B deduct statistics. Now, what are the basic postulates of the statistics? Here, the particles are indistinguishable and identical. You can't distinguish between them. Distinguish between the particles. They obey Pauli's exclusion principle. Pauli's exclusion principle means each energy state can accommodate either no particle or only one particle. So we discuss different problems on macrostate and microstate, and there, say 1, 2, 3 boxes were there. So there, if there are 3 boxes, then in each box, only one particle maximum can exist, either no particle or maximum one particle. That is the postulate of Fermi-Dirac statistics. So they obeys Pauli's exclusion principle. Particles obeys Pauli's exclusion principle. So each energy state can accommodate either no particle or only one particle. These particles have half integral spin. That means they can have h cross by 2. Spin values 3h cross by 2, 5h cross by 2 in this way. Next, the particles have antisymmetric wave functions as the number of particles have same quantum state. So these are the postulates. Now, what is the definition of fermion? Fermions are those indistinguishable. So if it is given, define fermion. So you have to say these particles are indistinguishable, they are identical, having half integral spin and obeys Fermi-Dirac statistics are called fermions. So this is the full definition. If you only say, generally the student says that the particles that obeys the Fermi-Dirac statistics, they are called fermions, but that you will not get marks, full marks for that. So you have to mention it is indistinguishable, identical, same type of particle, but you can't distinguish. And in MB statistics, it was distinguishable particles. That is, you can distinguish between the particles. Same type particle, but you can distinguish in MB statistics, but in FD statistics, you can't distinguish. So what are the example of fermions that obeys Fermi-Dirac statistics? That is electron, positron, neutron, protons. So they are called fermions, examples. Now, another some other definitions of fermions, that it has also been observed that if the total number of nucleons in an atom is odd, so see the atoms here, 1H3, 2He3, 3Li7, C6H13, etc. Here, see, that is the total number of nucleon. This is 3. This is the total number of nucleon. So here it is 3, total number of nucleon, total number of nucleon. Here it is 7, total number of nucleon. Here it is 13, the total number of nucleon. So here you can see, and this is the proton number. This is the mass number. That is total number of nucleon, proton number 1, 2, 3, 6. But it has been observed that if the total number of nucleons in an atom is odd, so 3 is odd, 3 is odd, 7 is odd, 13 is odd, then the atom or the molecules obey FD statistics. So all these four, they obey FD statistics. So these are the examples. The question is given, electron is a fermion, boson or boson. The particles which obey MB statistics, they are called boson. The particles which obey Bose-Einstein statistics, they are called boson. And the particles which obey FD statistics, they are called fermions. Now, if we consider, that is total number of, last day I discussed, that is total number of microstates according to MB statistics, it is given by GI factorial by NI factorial, GI minus NI factorial. Here, GI is greater than NI. Here, GI is greater than NI, as there must be at least one cell available for every particle. Now come to Fermi-Dirac distribution function. So Fe, this is very important. We are coming to the definition of Fermi energy. This is Fermi Dirac distribution function. Fe equal to Ni by Gi equal to 1 by 1 plus e to the power e to the power ei minus ef divided by kt. So you have to remember this. It is given in question. Write down the Fermi Dirac distribution function. And what is the Fermi Dirac distribution function? This gives the probability of a fermion to occupy an energy state ei at absolute temperature T. This gives the probability of a fermion to occupy an energy state ei at absolute temperature T. And what is EF? EF is the Fermi energy. K is the Boltzmann constant, which has these values. 1.38 into 10 to the minus 23 joule per Kelvin, or 8.62 into 10 to the minus 5 electron volt per Kelvin. So this gives the, so Fe is the probability of a fermion to occupy an energy state EI at absolute temperature T. So and EF, this is the Fermi energy. Now, here, you know this formula. Now, if we consider, if T equal to 0 and if EI less than EF, if T equal to 0, if we put here T equal to 0, so e to the power 1 by 0, so e to the power 1 by 0, 1 by 0 means what? Infinity.
Infinity.
And here, if EI is less than EF, if EI is less than EF, then it is minus, so minus of 1 by infinity, e to the power. So here you are getting this one. Fe equal to 1 by this one is here and this e to the power is here and e to the power minus infinity. So e to the power minus infinity, the value is 0. It is 0, e to the power minus infinity value. So Fe equal to 1. So if temperature is 0 here, 0 degree Kelvin, and EI is less than EF, then the probability of occupation of fermion is 1 of energy state EI occupation. That is, if EI is less than EF, then probability of occupation of fermion is 1. That is, all the energy states having EI less than EF are occupied by a single fermion, that is electron. So up to the state EF, when EI is less than, there are so many states, say E1, E2, E3, E4, E5, E6, EI, just EI take is E1, E3, E2, E4, in this way. So if EI is less than EF, so EF is that state, that is Fermi energy state. If T equal to 0, then all the energy states below that Fermi energy level, the probability of occupation of fermion is 1. Now here, if T equal to 0, if T equal to 0, but EI greater than EF. Here, EI is greater than EF. So this is plus e to the power plus 1 by infinity. So 1 by infinity here. So it is what you are getting as 1 by total infinity. That is 1 by infinity equal to 0. So Fe is 0. Now, probability of occupation of fermion is 0. So what we can conclude from here, so we can conclude, we can give the definition of Fermi energy from here. All the energy states having EI greater than EF are unoccupied. So if the energy is greater than Fermi energy, then all the energy states are unoccupied. And at T equal to 0, Fermi energy is that energy level up to which all the energy states are filled up by fermions. So at T equal to 0, what is the definition of Fermi energy? If EI at Fermi energy level is that level up to which all the energy states are filled up by fermions and above which all the energy states are empty. So above which all the energy, above Fermi energy level, all the energy states are empty. And up to which all the energy states are filled up by the single. So this is the graph. I'm just explaining the graph flatter. Now here, the Fermi energy level is the highest occupied energy level of a fermion at T equal to 0. So the Fermi energy level is the highest occupied energy level of fermion at T equal to 0. So after which, the all the energy states are empty. Now here, using the same relation, we are putting here what if t equal to greater than 0k. Initially we took that t equal to 0k, but here t greater than 0k, and if ei equal to f, then what will be the probability of fermion Fe? If you put it in the previous formula, then you will get 1 by 1 plus e to the power 0, that is half. Thus, for Fermi energy level, the probability of occupation of a fermion is half for any temperature T greater than 0K. So, in this way, we are considering T equal to 0K and T greater than 0K. Here, for T greater than 0K, probability of occupation of fermion is half when EI equal to EF. But here, at T equal to 0, if EI less than EF, probability of occupation of fermion is 1. And if EI is greater than EF, meaning above the Fermi level, the probability of occupation is 0. That means all the energy states are empty. Above greater than EF, all the energy states are empty. So here, this is the graph which is shown. That is in this direction, if EI is plotted, and here Fe, probability of occupation of fermion is plotted in this direction. And here it is 1, Fe value is 1. And here the Fe value is half. So you can say at T equal to 0K, you can see at T equal to 0K, this is the, what is the Fe value? That is 1. Okay, what is the value here? The Fe value is 1. Here, the value of Fe is 1. But here, see, and probability of occupation, if it is EI is greater than EF, here, EI is greater than EF, the probability of occupation is suddenly going to 0. It was here 1 up to this, but if EI is less than EF, if EI is less than EF, probability of occupation is 1. But here, if EI is greater than EF, the probability of occupation is directly going to 0. That is 0 here, 0. So this is the definition of Fermi energy level. And here you can say that the two temperatures are shown here. T1, T2 greater than T1, these are the two different temperatures. That is T greater than 0K. For this, probability of occupation, that is half, that I have shown here. The probability of occupation Fe value is half at EI equal to EF when T not equal to 0, that is T greater than 0K. So the probability of occupation at EI equal to EF is half. So if it is given, define Fermi energy. This is very important portion of statistical mechanics. And here, Fe versus EI curve, you have to show. And it will be given the defined Fermi energy and Fermi energy level and the probability of occupation or Fermi Dirac distribution function at zero and non-zero temperatures. Fermi Dirac distribution function at zero and non-zero temperatures. This graph is very important, and the explanation what I have given here, they are very important. Already it is given in note form. So now electron gas is metal. In metal, there is an overlapping between valence band and conduction band. You know, in metal, valence band and conduction band overlap. Due to this reason, a large number of free electrons are observed in metals. Thus, metals become a very good conductor. These free electrons move freely in the metal and continuously collide with the atoms. So, they behave like a gas, and this is called electron gas. Now, last day, I proved the expression of GEDE, expression of GEDE, number of quantum states within the energy range E to E plus D is given as GEDE. The total number of electrons in metal within the energy range E to E plus D is given as NEDE. NEDE is what? The total number of electrons in metal within the energy range E to E plus D, it is given by NEDE equal to GEDE divided by 1 by E to the power EI minus EF by KT plus 1. So here GEDE, I explained, that is the number of quantum states. You have to remember this. NEDE equal to, so what is this? So NEDE equal to Fe into GEDE. So Fe is what? 1 by this term, denominator. 1 by denominator term. That is equal to your Fe, Fermi Dirac distribution function. And NEDE equal to Fe into GEDE. So you can, so you know all these things, GPDP equal to this, huh? And E equal to P square by 2M. Last day I discussed all these things. And GD expression that you know here. So NED equal to GD, this expression I proved this last day. So you will put the value of GD here. So NED equal to, that is the value of, that is the value of GED. So GD into 1 by e to the power EI minus EF by KT plus 1. This is the Fermi-Dirac law of energy distribution for free electrons in metal. Remember, that is NED equal to GEDE into 1 by e to the power EI minus EF by KT plus 1. So NED equal to GD into FE, small FE, and small FE equal to 1 by root of 1 by this term. Now, the total number of energy, value of total energy or Fermi energy and the total number of electrons in metal at absolute zero. This is very important question. This is given frequently in exam. The expression of Fermi energy, prove the expression of Fermi energy and the total number of electrons in metal at absolute zero. At absolute zero, when T equal to zero, the total number of electrons is equal to the number of energy states occupied. In Fermi-Dirac distribution function, what is given? Just what I'm saying, you have total 8 particles. You have, say, total 8 electrons you have. You have total 8 electrons and 8 energy state you have. So 8 energy state you have. So in Fermi-Dirac distribution, you can't put more than one particle in one energy state. So 8 electrons, how many they will be distributed in 8 energy state? That is one electron in each energy state. So if we can count the total number of energy state, that will be the total number of electrons or fermions. So here it is written. At absolute temperature T equal to zero, the total number of electrons is equal to the total number of energy states occupied. So if we can find out at T equal to zero, the total number of electrons, then that will be the total number of energy states from zero to epsilon F. But above epsilon F, there are no particles. So we are considering between zero to Fermi energy, epsilon F, Fermi energy. So electrons are fermions. Therefore, each energy state has only one electron. Thus, at temperature, this is very important, T equal to 0K, the number of electrons, N, is equal to the total number of energy states. So if we can find out what will be the total number of energy states between 0 to epsilon F, that will be the total number of electrons. So here it is given, value of total energy and the total number of electrons in metal at absolute zero. So how we can find out the total number of electrons? We can, if we can found the total number of energy states, total number of energy states at T equal to 0K, how many energy states are there between zero to epsilon F, between zero to Fermi energy, then between zero to Fermi energy, then we will get the total number of electrons. So total number of electrons, N equal to GD. GD is the what? GD is the number of quantum states between E to E plus D. Now we are integrating this one between zero to epsilon F. So zero to Fermi energy in between, we are integrating this GD. So that will be the total number of electrons. So we are going to find out the total number of energy states within the energy range 0 to epsilon F. Why we are taking epsilon F? Because after epsilon F, the value of all the energy states are empty. So maximum value we are taking as epsilon F. So integrating over 0 to epsilon F and the energy, you know, the expression of GD, just it is given here. That last day I told you all, that is, you have to remember this expression of GD. So if this question is given directly, you will write where GEDE is the total number of energy states between E to E plus D. So we know this, just putting here, you know, E to the power half is there. So if you integrate 3 by 2, you will get. So 3 by 2 you are getting. This is the Fermi energy actually. 3 by 2 you are getting, just integrating. And so N equal to this. So what we have to find out, two questions are given. Find out the total number of electrons in metal at absolute zero. So this is the expression. And if it is given, find out the expression of Fermi energy, then epsilon F you have to find out. So epsilon F to the power 3 by 2 equal to this, and epsilon F equal to this. So this is the expression of Fermi energy. And what is the expression? Just this is simplification. Simplify. You have the notes also. So epsilon F equal to after simplification A square divided by 8m 3n by pi V whole to the power 2/3. So you have to remember this expression. Epsilon F equal to A square divided by 8m into 3n by pi V whole to the power 2/3. So this is the expression of Fermi energy. So Fermi energy depends on electrons concentration. So this is the expression of Fermi energy. This depends on the electrons concentration, that is n by v, and it is independent of the size and the volume of the conductors, and it is independent of the size and volume of the conductor. So this is very important relation. You will remember this expression. It may be given in MCQ also. You will get numerical problems following this, and I will give you some numericals later. So you have to solve, you have to may have to find out the value of n by v, you may have to find out the value of Fermi energy, or you may have to find out the value of n. So depending upon the problem. So this is the expression. So we have discussed what that is. At t equal to zero, the total number of electrons in metal at absolute zero, and the expression of Fermi energy. So this is now next, the mean internal energy epsilon bar of free electrons of a metal at absolute zero. This is also very important, frequently given this question, and also numericals depending upon this topic. The mean internal energy of free electrons of a metal at absolute zero equal to epsilon bar equal to 1 by capital N 0 to infinity E N E D E. Now what is capital N? Capital N is the total number of free electrons in a metal of volume capital P. Now NED equal to what? Total number of electrons in a metal within the energy range E to E plus D. Just before this, we have discussed what is NED. So NED is the total number of electrons in metal within the energy range E to E plus DE. Now this is the formula for the finding the mean internal energy of free electrons of a metal at absolute zero. This is the formula. Now we are writing here epsilon bar equal to what? 1 by N. Now see, this is 0 to infinity. So how we can divide this? We can divide this as 0 to epsilon and epsilon F to infinity. So ultimately 0 to infinity. So we are dividing this integration from 0 to epsilon F, and the next part is from epsilon F to infinity. Now here, see, now 1 by N, 0 to infinity. At first I am writing like this, then I am changing. Now E, this is E, this E is here. Then the expression of NED, expression of NED equal to small Fe into GED. And what was the small Fe value? That is 1 by that Fermi Dirac distribution function. That was 1 by E to the power
E minus E to EF.
So Fe
by plus 1.
So Fe, so small Fe into GED, that is the value of NED. So we are, it is given E into E capital E into NED, the value is given as Fe into GED. Now here that we are changing the integration from 0 to epsilon F and epsilon to infinity. So putting this, just dividing into integration part and calculating the first one and calculating the second one. Here come. At t equal to 0k, when I discuss Fermi Dirac distribution function, when I discuss the Fermi Dirac distribution function at t equal to 0k, if this is energy is less than Fermi energy or equal to Fermi energy, then what is the Fe? The distribution is Fermi Dirac distribution function is Fe is 1, the probability of finding the fermion at energy state Ei, that is Fe. So at when t equal to 0, up to, that means what? Up to Fermi energy level, all the energy states are filled up by the fermion, and after that all the energy states are empty. So up to EF, epsilon F, or less than epsilon F, up to epsilon F or less than epsilon F, all the energy states are filled up by fermion, though the probability of occupation of fermion is 1. But at t equal to 0, if E is greater than EF or equal to EF, then Fe equal to 0. I discussed earlier, just before this. So at T equal to 0, if it is less than EF energy, then Fe equal to 1. And at T equal to 0, if energy is greater than Fermi energy, the probability of occupation is 0. So the previous one, example. So only this portion will be only this portion remains and this portion vanishes, Ipsilon and F to infinity, because from Fermi energy to higher energy levels. So this portion does not exist because the probability of occupation of fermion is zero. So the value of, in the second part, the value of fermion, in the second part, the value of Fe, the value of Fe is zero. In the second part, the value of Fe is zero because we are considering in which region? The value of Fe equal to zero. Just a minute. The value of Fe equal to zero, so the second part does not exist. So which one exists? Only the first part. So zero to Ipsilon, that exists. Now Fe value is one here. And GED value you have to put. So ultimately again, Ipsilon bar equal to 1 by N, 0 to Ipsilon F, E into GED. So Fe value is 1 here. So GED expression you know, you will directly put it here. And just simple integration. So just simple integration. Here, you are getting e to the power 3 by 2 term. You are getting into the power 3 by 2 term. So just integrating, it will be 5 by 2. Now this is, so it is Ipsilon bar equal to this. Ipsilon bar equal to this. But here, some trick is here. That is, how will you write this Ipsilon F to the power 5 by 2? I'm writing this as Ipsilon F to the power 3 by 2 into Ipsilon F. I'm dividing these two parts. Why we are dividing? Because we know that directly the expression of Ipsilon to the power 3 by 2 from the previous relation. You will remember this thing, that is previous relation means where? Ipsilon to the power 3 by 2. Ipsilon to the power 3 by 2, you know, directly put it there. Directly put it here. Ipsilon to the power 3 by 2, put it here. And keep Ipsilon F as it is. Don't change it. Don't put the value of Ipsilon F. Just divide that Ipsilon F 5 by 2 into 3 by 2 into Ipsilon F.
Silent.
The value of 3 by 2 Ipsilon F. Ipsilon F to the power 3 by 2 only. And just write, keep as it is.
Okay.
Now, putting the value, we are getting Ipsilon bar equal to 3 by 5 Ipsilon F. This is the formula. The mean internal energy of free electron at absolute zero. That is, if you, that will be, just calculate, simply calculate it, you will get this one. Why I kept it just Ipsilon F? Why? Because the answer is this, no? So I have divided that Ipsilon to the power 5 by 2 into two parts, 3 by 2 and Ipsilon F. As in final expression, Ipsilon is F is there. So Fermi energy. As in this expression, Fermi energy is there. So we are not changing this part. And you just put the value of Ipsilon F. And this this is the cancellation you are getting. So ultimately, this is the expression. So 3 by 5 Ipsilon F. So this is the expression. This is the relation between the mean internal energy of electron of a free electron of metal at T equal to 0K to its Fermi energy at absolute zero. This is the relation. So mean internal energy, what type of numerical is given here? The numericals are given like this. Epsilon bar, you have to remember this Fermi energy value. Very important question, very easy question. This may be given in MCQ, the expression of mean internal energy. So it is directly proportional to Ipsilon F, which is 3 by 5. That is equal to, it is 3 by 5 Ipsilon F. Ipsilon F value will be given. Say in EV electron volt, the value is given. You have to find out the mean. So very easy. Just you will put the value here and you will find out what will be the Ipsilon bar. That is main internal energy. So this is very, very important. The deduction in formula statistics, it is what type of question is given. I'm just repeating. In formula statistics, it is given that from the starting, I'm saying what you will remember in FT statistics. In FT statistics, what how will you remember? First, the question is given, write down the basic postulates of FT statistics. This is the first question. Then the question is given, what define fermions with examples? This is the second question. Some examples we will be given. Say, neutron is which type of particle? it will be given neutron. So neutron is fermion, electron is fermion, positron is fermion, proton is fermion, 1 He3, that is 2 He3, 3 Li7, lithium, say 6 C13, that are all obeys Fermilab statistics, because here the total number of nucleons here 7 13 3, they are all odd. So we can say that they are all obeying Fermilab statistics. Now this is the formula I have to remember, the number of microstates or number of quantum states for Fermilab statistics, GI factorial by NI, GI minus NI factorial. And last day I also calculated, one problem was given, some problems were given on this microstates number or the total number of quantum states. G is the total number of, there you calculated the total number of boxes, and N is the total number of particles. If there are three boxes, if there are two particles in three boxes, then two particles in three boxes, then in FT statistics, it is 3 and it is 2. So 3 minus 2. So here it was the condition, the GI, it can't be less than NI because you can't distribute them. So GI is always greater than NI, GI. So as it is, the value is GI minus NI is here. So GI is always greater than NI. So this formula you have to remember. And I told you that is different type of system is given. Three particles in two boxes, two particles in, according to different statistics, NDB and FD statistics, calculate the total number of macrostates and microstates it is given. So remember this formula. And it is given frequently, and that question also given, compare the postulates of MB statistics, B statistics and FD statistics. Compare, when you will compare, in every statistics you have to write down the microstates, what will be the total number of microstates or the total number of quantum states, you have to calculate, write down. So that is, then FD, write down the Fermi-Dirac distribution function, it is given, you have to write it. And definition of Fermi-Dirac distribution function, very important. Then expression of Fermi energy, and explain Fermi energy equal to T equal to 0 and T non-zero, T no, greater than 0k. Express or explain Fermi energy at T equal to 0k and T greater than 0k. Then all these things you have to discuss, and you have to say, you have to draw the graph also, and you have to define that T equal to 0k, Fermi energy level is that energy level up to which all the energy states are filled up by single fermion, and above which all the energy are unoccupied or there are no fermions above epsilon F. So these are the definitions. Then electron gas, just this is for your concept. And you know here, you have to remember NED equal to 1 Fe into GD, that's expression. Then after that, this is very important. Expression of Fermi energy and the total number of electrons in metal and absolute. This is very, very important. Important this one. Find out the total number of electrons in metal and absolute zero, and also find out the expression of Fermi energy. So this is the, N is the total number of electrons in metal at absolute zero, and epsilon F, that is the expression of Fermi energy, and that is A square divided by into 3N by pi B whole to the power 2/3. So this is, now it is depending, this is very important, Fermi energy depends on electrons concentration N by V, depending on the factor N by V, and it is independent of size and volume of the conductor. Last, mean internal energy of the electrons at absolute zero, epsilon bar equal to 1 by N 0 to infinity E NED. So NED equal to Fe into GD, that is the value of NED. Now putting the values, now we are integrating over 0 to infinity, but for that what I will do, we will divide it into separate parts, 0 to epsilon F and epsilon F to infinity. And for the second part, above Fermi energy, this is epsilon F to infinity, this is the above Fermi energy level. So the value of Fe equal to, for this portion, it is 0. So the second part is not active here. So the second part is not active here. Fe is 0. So, and for the first part, Fe is 0. So, we are only considering this part, because here Fe equal to 0 and Fe equal to 0. So, considering the first part, this is just integrating. After integrating, we are getting what? So, This is epsilon not equal to this total. So we are dividing that epsilon to the power 5 by 2 plus 3 by 2. 3 by 2 and epsilon f. We are getting epsilon to the power 3 by 2 and epsilon f. So ultimately, epsilon to the power 3 by 2 and as it is epsilon f. So ultimately, we are finding out the value. Actually, the value is here. As when we have the expression of Fermi, 3 by 2 epsilon f. So this is the relation between the mean internal energy, free electron of metal at t equal to 0 k, to its Fermi energy at absolute zero. So this is the relation between the mean internal energy and the Fermi energy. Relation between mean internal energy and Fermi energy at absolute zero. So remember this expression of Fermi energy and expression of total number of electrons equal to zero. So, today up to this, and next day, tomorrow, are you all free?
No, ma'am.
Tomorrow, which class you have?
Humanities.
From 12 noon, which class you have?
Humanities ka hai, ma'am.
Kya hai humanities ka?
Yes, ma'am.
Then after that, from 2:30.
Free at 2:30, sir.
You are free though? You are all free from 2:30?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then tomorrow I will take the class from 2:30. Okay.
मैम एक बात और है.
बोलो.
मकाउट का वेबसाइट पे वीकली एक्टिविटी रिपोर्ट सबमिट करने के लिए है मैम, तो उसमें मतलब क्या भरेंगे हम लोग?
तो क्या भरेंगे, जो पढ़ाना हो रहा है वो भरो. अपने आप कुछ इधर उधर उतना भी देख के कुछ भी भरो, ठीक है? मतलब तुम भी एक
मतलब सबका
कुछ भी कैसे भर दे.
सुनो, हम जो भर रहे हैं ना हर दिन, ठीक है, सुनो, हम जो एक्टिविटी तुम लोगों को दे रहे हैं ना, सब्जेक्ट वाइज भरना पड़ रहा है. तो
यस मैम,
हम भी भर रहे हैं, हम जो भर रहे हैं ना उधर, हम वो तुमको तुम लोगों को सेंड कर देंगे, ठीक है?
ठीक है.
हर दिन देना इम्पोर्टेंट नहीं है, कुछ मतलब भरते रहो, जो भी क्लास हो रहा है भरते रहो. हम भी कर रहे हैं, क्योंकि वीक में तो मानो एक एक वीक में 7 दिन करके दे रहे हैं, तो 7 दिन में तो 7 क्लास तो हो नहीं रहा है, ठीक है? जो भी क्लास हो रहा है उसको भर दो.